Logging is widespread in tropical rainforests around the world. Although illegal logging is pervasive, legal selective reduced-impact timber production also takes place in large areas of these forests. In reduced-impact logging, companies operating in a given forest area must comply with the standards of a third-party certification system, such as that of the Forest Stewardship Council, or FSC. These standards promote strict social and environmental practices, such as minimizing the number of roads constructed, leaving alone certain sensitive areas, and controlling hunting. The FSC standard is specifically attentive to the protection of biodiversity, but are FSC regulations sufficient to help wildlife thrive in certified logging concessions? This is the question we set out to answer. To do so, we install large-scale camera trap grids in logging concessions in Peru and Guatemala. The Peruvian grid covered an area of 645 square kilometers, while the area of the Guatemalan grid was 520 square kilometers. Camera traps are excellent tools for documenting the presence of large and medium-sized mammals. Although we were particularly interested in the top predator, the jaguar, the cameras detected 25 mammal species in Peru and 22 in Guatemala. We saw some nice birds as well, but our focus was on the mammals. We were able to estimate the jaguar density by individually identifying 43 jaguars in Peru and 23 in Guatemala. Even though the study took place in logging concessions, occupancy values for many mammal species were comparable to those of other study sites, including protected areas. We found that logging had no negative impact on any of the species in the examined concessions. What's more, recently logged areas had even higher numbers of certain herbivore species, including deer, tapir, and agouti. A possible explanation is that logging opens up the forest canopy in places where trees are harvested and along logging roads, which in turn leads to an increase in understory vegetation consumed by these herbivores. Surprisingly, animals didn't avoid logging roads, and some carnivores even made frequent use of them. These findings indicate that if the certification standards are met, and thus hunting and timber extraction are controlled, large and medium-sized mammal populations can be sustained in well-managed logging concessions, but it's exceptionally important to respect the strict restrictions on hunting and to forbid outsider access to logging roads. Enforcement of management practices by governments, along with third-party organizations such as the FSC, is key for maintaining high biodiversity in these logging areas. With that, well-managed logging might be a good activity for local communities in buffer zones around protected areas, as it causes less impact on the forest and leads to less human-wildlife conflict compared to some of the alternative activities, such as agriculture or cattle ranching.